I'm a marine science major. I chose that major because I knew I really liked science. I loved my introduction to chemistry and AP chemistry in high school. But I knew I didn't want to be in the lab all the time. So I knew that either environmental or marine science would allow me to do a lot of outdoor field work and would put me into environments that I've never encountered before, which is something really important to me, to get outside of my comfort zone. Usually I'm working out at Stennis. I work in a marine geochemistry lab. I have a really diverse skill set because of the lab that I work in, and I love that I get to work there. It's awesome. But today I'm here at Gulf Park attending some classes. I try to stack my classes on a couple of days here just so I can spend more time over at Stennis developing my lab skills, doing lab work for my thesis, and working on writing my thesis. Okay, so the class I just came from was marine environmental science, and in that class it seems like we are going to look at a variety of different topics, like hot topics in the field of marine environmental science, and we're going to have a lot of class discussions about them to discuss like possible solutions and mechanisms that we can use to communicate this to a larger non-scientific audience. And then we're going to debate between the students on either side of these issues to really get a holistic view of the issues facing marine science in the wake of climate change. Right now I'm going to seminar, and in seminar we are learning public speaking skills as they relate to the field of marine science. And here we'll not only be learning how to communicate to the scientific audience, but we'll be learning how to communicate to the general public, governmental agencies, and political figures. So I'm thankful that I ended up going to college, because without my education, I would not be able to experience things like going out on research cruises or participating in internships far away from where I'm from, getting me out of my comfort zone. And I wouldn't have met the network of people that have allowed me to grow not only as a human being, but as a scientist.